Yes, it is, yeah. True, you are way maker.
Hey. Let's sing this together. Even when I don't see it. Come on, even when.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working.
Come on!
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop.
Depression. His name is above loneliness. Oh, his name is above disease. His name is above cancer. His name is above every other name. He says, that is who.
Good morning, Brighterside Church. Good morning. Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday, October 22nd. Hope you all are having a fantastic day. It is Sunday. And welcome back to Brighterside Church for your worship session for this wonderful Sunday. I'm going to be honest, this week has been awful rough. Okay? That's all I'm going to say. I feel the devil has been attacking us, so me, I don't know about you, but me and my family, he has been attacking us and attacking us and attacking us more and more and more all throughout this week. I'm going to be honest, I did not even feel like stepping up to the pulpit today. I did not even feel like worshiping or preaching today. So I do apologize if nothing sounds very good, if I'm kind of not really peppy, but I'm feeling a lot better. I got my coffee. Jesus is on my side, in my heart, and he is with us today. He is helping us go through. So welcome back to Brighterside Church. Today we're actually starting a sermon that is titled Setting the Course to Enter Higher Dimensions. Again, Setting the Course to Enter Higher Dimensions. The scripture we're going to look at today is Nehemiah 2, verse 20. And this sermon is about what we must do in order to enter a higher dimension of blessing and fruitfulness in our life. So whether we are stuck and you've been going through trouble like we have this week, this is going to be a good sermon just for me to preach, because it's going to actually help me and my family as well. But any of you out there, if you just feel like you're not receiving your blessing, you're not receiving fruitfulness, you're not getting that lovely fruit, you need to set the course to enter those higher dimensions. So that's what I have made to preach on for today, and this will be a good one for me already. I've learned a lot from this sermon. So, with that being said though, let's jump out to a song and we will come on back and collect our offering, and then we'll drop in one more song, and then we will go come in to actually do our sermon, and then we'll dismiss for the day. So let's jump out, stand up to your feet, let's worship the Lord this morning.
The verdict was guilty, case closed, the end. No chance for me to ever leave this prison of my sin. Now I know it might sound crazy, but one day a key unlocked that cell. I heard a small voice say your debt's been paid by somebody else. And now I'm walking, walking, walking. Nothing perfect, I still stumble every single day. I still get knocked down, but the difference now is that's not where I stay. Cause I got a Savior who knows everywhere I've been, and he's telling me that I never have to go back there again. So now I'm walking, walking, walking. Look up and see your victory is just up ahead. Cause there is a Savior who knows everywhere you've been, and he's telling you that you never have to go back there again. So if you know that,
okay, welcome back. So, I am now here to collect your tithe and your offering. If you would love to fulfill God's promise and bless this ministry here today, there are many different ways that you can give. On our YouTube channel or even in the podcast, down in the description box of every single video that is posted for our church, you will find a big description box. You can give by going to our website, which is https://austinluxurylife12.wixsite.com/brightersidechurch. God gives us all the luxuries in life, and He has given me one luxurious life. I am so thankful for whatever and everything that I have received from Him. But you can go online there and you will find our webpage with our quick action buttons, and you will find our tithe and offering for Venmo, PayPal, and Cash App to give online. If you want to give with a debit card, credit card, or a check, you can do so by calling 814-429-3790. Or if you would prefer, you may also email PastorAustinBSC@gmail.com. Now, if no one's available to answer that phone line for you, just leave your debit or credit card number in the voicemail box. It is a fully confidential voicemail box. If you don't feel comfortable doing it that way, you can send a text. It is a one-time offering unless you request that you want a monthly or weekly offering given to Brighterside Church. But to help fulfill God's promise and to bless the ministry here at Brighterside Church, your tithe and offering would do us such a great thing. That is how we are taking the worship and the experience and the preaching and God to the entire country, to the entire world, to the entire universe, is through tithe and offerings. So we thank you so much for your wonderful gift. Now, let's jump back out to a song, and we'll be right back to begin our sermon, which is titled, Setting the Course to Enter Higher Dimensions.
Working in town one afternoon, attending some business affairs. I heard a commotion a couple streets over and wondered what's happening there. A young man was running from in that direction and stopped just to catch his breath. I asked him to please tell me what was the hurry. He smiled up at me and he said, I was trying to catch the crippled man. Did he run past this way? He was rushing home to tell everyone what Jesus did today. And the mute man was telling myself and the deaf girl he's leaving to answer God's call. It's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me, ask the blind man, he saw it all. Ask the blind man, he saw it all. Troubles and burdens you carry are heavy and dragging you down. And you've tried everything you can possibly think of, but there's no relief to be found. That very same Jesus that altered the future of the blind man, the deaf and the lame, is still reaching out in your hour of trouble. Touch and you're never the same. And you'll be trying to catch the crippled man. Did he run past this way? He was rushing home to tell everyone what Jesus did today. And the mute man was telling myself and the deaf girl he's leaving to answer God's call. It's hard to believe, but if you don't trust me, ask the blind man, he saw it all. Ask the blind man, he saw it all. He saw it all.
Back. So again, good morning everyone. I hope you all are having a wonderful Sunday. let's go ahead and get started today with our sermon. But before we do, I do want to get our devotional here and have an opening prayer before we get started today. So let me go ahead and get us a prayer to get us going. Last week we held a prayer for Israel, for what they're currently going through right now. So please, everyone, continue to pray for Israel. We have to pray for Israel. They are going through a lot of trouble and trial right now. And I believe this is the devil trying to take over. And it's not going to happen, because the devil is nothing but a coward. He cannot withstand God. God will demolish him. Okay, let's go ahead. Let's pray. Glorious Jesus, you are the firm foundation on which we can dance and sing and celebrate your glorious presence. We receive this precious gift as your high and holy calling for us. You've shown us that glorifying and enjoying you is the vastly more important thing, more important than maintaining a tidy, structured life. Still, our natural tendency is to pour our energy into trying to keep everything under control. Help us relinquish this striving to be in control, recognizing that it's both an impossible task and an affront to your faithfulness. We realize that you guide each of your children individually. That's why we're listening. That's why listening to you through scripture and prayer is essential for us to find the way forward. Please prepare us for the day that awaits us and point us in the right direction, because you are with us continually. We don't have to be intimidated by fear, though it stalks us. We know it can't harm us as long as we cling to your hand. Instead of being fearful, we want to walk trustingly with you along our pathway, enjoying peace in your presence. In your high and holy name, amen. And some scripture that surrounds our prayer and devotional today is Psalm 5, verse 11, Lamentations 3, verse 22 through 23, and Jude 24 through 25. I do want to take a moment just to say, if you do need a Bible or any other supplies, like any other books, or you found a book that you would love to have, but you're unable to afford that book at this time, a quick reminder though, just try to put your money back for it, even if it's a dollar at a time. But if you're unable to afford it at all, and you have a really hard time getting it, Bible, whatever it may be, please reach out to us through our email or our phone line. Again, that email address, PastorAustinBSC@gmail.com, and that phone line, 814-429-3790. And we will be here to help you get the supplies that you need to include God into your life. And like I previously stated, any tithe and offerings, they will also go to help people get what they need, help them get supplies they need, and all of that. And it will bless the whole entire world here, because almost every single nation is watching us. So our videos are out there for everyone to come in and worship all across the world. With that being said, though, let's go ahead and get started. Again, I'm Pastor Austin. Good morning. I am founder and lead pastor of Brighterside Church, and I'm here today to do today's preaching sermon, which is Setting the Course to Enter Higher Dimensions. So, we have to set the course to enter higher dimensions. There is going to be a few different parts that we're going to look at today. We're going to look at expectation, effort, enthusiasm, energy, enlightenment, endurance, extent, and all of that is the message, setting the course to enter higher dimensions. Now let's start with our first section of today's sermon, which is all about expectation. This is focusing on the scripture of Nehemiah 2 verse 20 and John 5 verse 5 through 9. Now, to enter higher dimensions in life, we must raise the level of our expectations. We must expect great things from God. Nehemiah expected the blessings of God in his endeavors. We must not allow past failures to cause us to lose hope. Jesus met a paralytic who could not receive his cure for 38 years. Those repeated failures had caused him to lose hope. But Jesus raised his expectation and performed a miracle for him. We must raise the level of our expectation to enter higher dimensions in life and receive those blessings and that fruitfulness from God. Looking into our second part, which is effort. This is focusing on the sermon or on the scriptures of Romans 12 verse 11 and John 4 verse 34. Now again, to enter higher dimension life, we must raise the level of our efforts. Now we must work harder and put in more effort. We must pay the price for the rewards that we seek. We must not be slothful, but be fervent in the Spirit and serve the Lord. We must not waste our time and squander our energy in vain pursuits. We must be focused on our main objectives. Now, Jesus was completely dedicated to fulfill the purpose for which he came to this world. He considered that as his meat and nourishment. We must raise the level of our efforts to higher dimensions in life. If we can't raise our efforts, it's like a job. If you can't work hard enough, you're not going to get paid enough. So we have to raise our efforts to receive our blessings and our fruitfulness from God. Next is enthusiasm. And for enthusiasm, we are just going to read 2 Chronicles 31 verse 21 and Colossians 3 verse 23. Let's read. Let's read 2 Chronicles 31 verse 21. In everything that he undertook in the service of God's temple and in obedience to the law and the commands, he sought his God and worked wholeheartedly, and so he prospered. Colossians 3 verse 23, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Enthusiasm. We need to have intense and eager enjoyment and interest and approval in God and truly live our lives for Him. If we're waking up in the morning and we're thinking all about money or all about our car or all about our bills or all about our other troubles, God is not going to help us. He's going to try to help us, but we're not putting Him first. So how can we expect to get His help first? Next, we're looking at energy. Now, this is focusing on Acts 10, verse 38, and Isaiah 40, verse 29 through 31. To enter higher dimensions in life, we also must raise the level of our energy. We must seek to be endured with greater power from God. Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, and he went about doing good, healing all who were oppressed with the devil. We must wait on God to receive his power and strength in order to be a blessing to suffering humanity. We can't run out and just help people right that minute. God has to give us that enlightenment. So as soon as you go to help him, ask God, God, please help me with this. And that goes for everything, not just helping people. It goes along with that whole entire energy. You have to receive God's energy to be able to do what you need to do. So ask him before you go for a test, Lord, please give me the energy to be able to do this. You know, all this week I've been down and just really depressed and been sitting in bed and not really doing that well. I haven't been getting up and doing anything. I have just been lounging. Well, today that makes the difference. I've asked the Lord Jesus to give me the energy, give me that greater power energy from God that was anointed with the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit would give me the power to be able to move on with my day and keep that energy. We must raise the level of our energy to enter the higher dimensions in life. Section 5, enlightenment. That focuses on scriptures John 8 verse 32 and Corinthians 2 verses 9 through 10. To enter higher dimensions in life, we must raise the level of our enlightenment. We must know the truth, which will bring freedom in our life. As we receive more and more enlightenment of the truth, we will experience more and more freedom in our life. With the help of the Holy Spirit, we can know what God has prepared for us and reach out for it. We must raise the level of our enlightenment to enter higher dimensions in life. And six, our next part, endurance, second to last. Our scripture that we're surrounding on is Proverbs 24 verse 10 and Timothy 2 verse 3. To enter higher dimensions in life, we must raise the level of our endurance. We must not faint or get discouraged easily. If we faint in the day of adversity, R is small. If we faint in the day of adversity, our endurance is small. Our strength is revealed in times of adversity and trials. We must endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. At the time of birth, there is an associated labor pain. I think all women probably know that one. Even so, in our life, when the time comes for the promises of God to be fulfilled in our life, and when the vision we carry in our heart is about to be birthed, we must not be surprised or discouraged when there is an intense travail of the soul before the blessing comes. We must raise the level of our endurance to enter higher dimensions in life. Lastly, 7, extent. This is surrounded on 1 Chronicles 4 verse 10 and Isaiah 54 verses 2 through 3. And lastly, to enter higher dimensions in life, we must raise the level of our extent and boundaries. If we restrict our boundaries, we will not be able to expand beyond a level. Our vision and desire must be growing. Jabez prayed that God should bless him and enlarge his territory, and God granted his request. God wants to enlarge our territory and extent on all sides. He cannot do that unless we fully see beyond those boundaries. Even though there's a wall there, we can break that wall down and we can go through. There's no reason why you can't go through the door. You have to be willing to open that door and break that boundary. You have to be willing to break the border and go over the border. There is no open borders, but you have to go through the borders. We must do that to raise the level of our extent to enter higher dimensions in life. So, looking back, once you applied all of these things to your life, and you've received the higher dimension. What is a higher dimension? People probably think, what is the higher dimension? What I'm talking about is receiving God's blessing, feeling a lot better about yourself and your life, not being depressed as often as you used to be. Now, yes, you're still going to be. Who isn't? But with God, things are going to be so much better in your life, and you can't enter that higher dimension, feel better, whenever you will not receive the blessing and fruitfulness of your life. You have to set the course before you can receive the grade. So make sure to apply all 7 of those things into your life: expectation, effort, enthusiasm, energy, enlightenment, endurance, extent. Apply all of them. Now I'm going to move into kind of like the second part of this sermon, which I have kind of titled, you know, you are higher than them. Okay, no one's higher than anybody else through themselves. We shall not be prideful, but a lot of us are higher than those who are with the devil because we are with God, okay? So, a lot of people take time to listen to people who are just very complainy. They complain about everything. They try to make everything into something negative. They are what we call narcissists. A few months ago, we had a service that was surrounded around narcissists, and that was posted on our YouTube channel, and it was also posted on our podcast. I forget exactly which service that was, but it was one of them. And we talked all about narcissists. I'm taking a look here. It was 1 month ago. Attitudes, Narcissists, and Nastiness. And that was a service that was that came out on September 3rd. So that was our service there. Okay. So If you want to go back and listen back to that one, you're more than able to. But there are so many narcissists around the world, around our life. We may even have one in our family. They are people that have nothing nice to say. Everything you do say, they are able to turn into something nasty and rude. They always make it negative. They have nothing but negative things to say about everything that you do. No matter what you do and how you do it, nothing is ever good enough for how they want it. If you cook them food, it's never cooked right. If you bring them a cup of coffee, it's never the right one. If you clean something for them, it's never clean enough. Nothing's ever done the correct way for a narcissist. People will get to understand that. You will never do something good enough for a narcissist. They are around us in all of our lives. They are surrounded by us. We are surrounded with them all around the world. In life, some of them are, like I said, are in our homes, etc., etc., etc. So the way I think about this that goes along with the higher dimension is that once we are dealing with these type of people who are never happy with anything, they always turn around stories and make them negative and then make themselves the hero. And they lie. They're a manipulative liar. Whenever those people come into this dimension, they cannot come into this dimension. So I thought this would be a good sermon to add on to that, that those people who you're always frustrated with are always below you. How are they below you? I like to say that God gave us some beautiful, heavenly given high heels, and we are just like way up there. Now, the big mistake that people do is they throw rocks, okay? If you guys want a good song to listen to after today's service, take this note down. It's Rocks by the Isaacs. Definitely check it out. The lyrics goes, actually, you know what? Never mind. I can actually play you guys this song right here today. So let's go ahead and let's play Rocks by the Isaacs right now, and we'll come right back.
There's a lot of people talking about people, looking down on everybody, acting like they're sitting on a steeple, keeping all their own faults locked up in a big vault, forgetting that God don't need a combination to see it all.
Raise your hand if you ain't ever done nothing wrong.
That's what I thought.
Rocks are heavy, and they hurt people you love. And it's so easy reaching down and picking them up. But I ain't gonna throw no stones at nobody. Drawing on the ground beside her, she was caught red-handed, and man, they all couldn't wait to stone her. Now I'm just paraphrasing, but Jesus said, oh, wait a minute, step right up and be the first to throw if you ain't done some sinning. One by one they all dropped their stones and went home. Rocks are heavy, and they hurt people you love. And it's so easy reaching down and picking them up. But I ain't gonna throw no stones at nobody. Stone.
So, how we like it? Rocks by the Isaacs. So, like I was getting ready to say, we don't want to be throwing rocks down from our higher dimension. So what's the best thing to do in our higher dimension to not bring ourselves down? I'm going to say, by doing what they do, by yelling and screaming back at them, by giving them a nasty attitude, even by cursing or swearing at them, that can happen. Anybody can sin. I don't care if you've been a Christian for 99 years, you can still sin. Instead of doing that, instead of getting lost in this battle, this ongoing battle of arguing and bickering and fighting with this person who's doing all of these problematic things, the best thing that we can possibly do is stay in our higher dimension. Just say to ourselves, God is King. Jesus is King. Jesus is my Lord and my Savior. He will be the next King. I need to focus my life on Him. He is giving me glorious heavenly high heels, and I am so much higher, way up on this massive stone. I am up in Yosemite in California. I am on my way to the New Jerusalem. Do not bring yourself back down. Do not yank back all the way down and drop down their dimension. Drop back down into their ditch. They are lower than the normal ground because of how nasty they are. God wants to help them so bad, but He cannot help them if they do not want to accept His help. He tries and tries and tries, but they will not accept His help. So I'm here to say that all to you today, to just keep on going. Stay in your higher dimension. Stay on your stone. Work your way to the New Jerusalem, and everything good you do, you are planting treasures for yourself in heaven. Now, with all of that being said, I want to thank you all for attending Brighterside Church today. This was a shorter service, definitely, but we will have longer services as we go on. But like I said, it was very hard for me to sit down and take these notes and work out this sermon today. So I do apologize that it was a little bit more short, but I hope you all have a fantastic and phenomenal rest of your week. If you would like, you can give that tithe and that offering, the instructions at the beginning of today's episode and down below and over on our website so you can view those today. And with that being said, that's going to be it for today's episode, for today's worship session. Have a phenomenal rest of your week ahead, and I will see you all in our next worship session. I want to allow all of you just some time to enjoy a minute or two of this calm music and scenery on your way out. May God bless you all and have a great day, but God is working. No matter our troubles, no matter our trials, God is there to provide. It says so in all kinds of different scriptures that God is there to provide for us, that He is in control, that God is our Father, that God is all-powerful. A big verse that stands for that is Deuteronomy 3, verse 22. Do not be afraid of them. The Lord your God Himself will fight for you. Psalm 44, verse 3. It was not by their sword that they had won the land, nor did their arm bring the victory. It was your right hand, your arm, and the light of your face, for you love them. Isaiah 42, verse 13. The Lord will march out like a champion, like a warrior. He will stir up His zeal. With a shout, He will raise the battle cry, and He will triumph over His enemies. Proverbs 20, verse 22. Do not say, I'll pay you back, for this is wrong. Wait for the Lord, and He will avenge you. And lastly, to end off and let you guys enjoy some peaceful parts for the end of today's service, Psalm 27, verse 13 through 14. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Enjoy some more calmness and relaxation for your way out, and allow the Lord to come into your life and apply His wonderful abundance to your life. The Holy Spirit wants to help you. It wants to be within you. It wants to glaze your home in its wonderful honey. Allow the Holy Spirit, allow God, allow the Lord Jesus to take over in your life. I wish you all the best. God God bless, and have a great week ahead. I'll see you in our next worship session. Thank you all for attending BSC. Our Twitter page, our email, and our website are linked, and we'll see you in our next worship session. Have a great day.